Hello everyone, welcome back. I took a break over the holidays, but I've already started to think about some new products, and I can show you, I scripted out my idea of the next shop updates for the whole year, considering holidays and sales. And now I've got this handsome little rainbow calendar, and I've marked myself sometimes for vacation sales and shop updates and stuff like that. I have a bunch of new products that I want to design and sew and create. I have a bunch of patterns. What I will do today is sew some project bags. This is one that I did last week. It's like a smaller one, a little drawstring bag. Yeah, but I also want to do one like this, only in bigger. This is what I will do now. Hello everyone. You can just open it up. This is the bigger one. And then you can maybe close it, open it, put in all the wool that you would use if you wanna. Yeah. This is the knitting bag that I'm using until now. I hope it gets sharper. I've got this design from Urban Threads. It just opens up like that. These are some socks I'm knitting for like 2 years now. I'm really, really slow at knitting. But I dyed the wool by myself. But I fear that these will be too big for me, so maybe I will frog them all. Which would be a bit sad because it was a lot of work. Fun fact, the bottom of these is like hexagon, and these ones, the smaller ones, have a triangle as bottom. I will definitely keep this one and this one. And I'm thinking that I will use this one for knitting and use this one maybe for English paper piecing. Let me see. This is my sew together bag I made like 2 years ago, I think. There's also another knitting project in here, and a lot of other stuff, but not the ones that I'm looking for. Wait a second. Didn't find exactly what I was looking for, but English paper piecing is like you've got some paper forms, and you use these, like you put them in the middle of a piece of fabric, and then you
just lay the edges around it. And then you have these pieces of fabric, and then you can sew them together and have stuff like that. I have made it some time ago, and I'm still not sure what I will use it for.
What I will do today? I want to make a cover for letter writing stuff, like letter paper and some.
So I want to show you my finished fabrics that I will use to make project bags. I really like this one with the skeletons in the green and blue. And then I've got this colorful happy one. And then I've got a black and white one with red and gray and pink. And there are cats in the background who get food. Really loud cats. And there is this one with more natural colors. Hello everyone, it's a new day. Yesterday I ironed all of the four fabrics or patchworks. But I didn't film anything because my memory cards were all full. And right now I'm copying all to my computer. What we're doing now is being interrupted by cats. I started cutting out my pattern pieces. I started with this fabric. I already have two of the... like this one. And this one. This will be the sides of my project bags. Like, there are, there's the camera. There are three side pieces and then a bottom piece. I think I will make the bottom piece out of some, not out of these patchwork fabrics, but out of some single fabric, if one can say that. And then I will use some basic color for the inside, and I think one of the outside fabrics I will use for the inside pockets. But right now I'm all about cutting out these pieces, and I will show you a time lapse of it. So I just did my hair, and somehow the curls look really, really good today. Hello again. Today I will finally sew the project bags together. I have some light to try to get awake because it is quiet out there. There's a cat. There's my camera because I will film the process for my next studio vlog, for the studio vlog you're watching now. Great. And this is a bunch of fabric all cut out. As a final step, I added some drawstrings to the bags. Now they are finished. I only need to take photos of them and add them to my Etsy store. I will make the shop update with these on the same Sunday where this video that you are watching right now will go live on YouTube. So check out my Etsy store. Also check out my Instagram. And you could even take a look at my TikTok. Also, if you liked that video, click on the like button. And I hope you're staying warm and safe in these weird times. See you next time. Bye.